Hallo, I'm Rupa Mukherjee. I work for Helvetas and I've written the lead essay for the Global Hunger Index 2019. Based on data and evidence, the Global Hunger Index 2019 says that hunger, after declining for about three decades, is once again on the rise. Between 2015 and today, there's been a steady increase in the number of people hungry across the world. In 2018, about 822 million people were hungry in different parts of the world. The reasons for persistence of hunger are several. They're poverty, inequality, conflict, war, extreme events like floods and droughts. All of these are aggravated by climate change. Climate change is actually a stress multiplier in the current situation. Climate change impacts all dimensions of the food system, so production, transport, processing, but also the nutritive quality of the food that we consume. Climate change and the responses to it, so adaptation and mitigation, also have strong interfaces with hunger. The Paris Agreement and its ambition to restrict global warming to less than 2 degrees centigrade incorporates bioenergy and carbon capture and sequestration measures on a massive scale. All of this are based on land, and between 2030 and 2050, they envisage about 2 million hectares being used per year for bioenergy and carbon capture and sequestration measures. This will have deep impacts on food security, competition for land that is used for food production, and here we need to ensure that the trade-offs are not damaging for the people who are already poor and vulnerable on this earth. It's very important that food security remains at the center of all policies, including climate policy. The poor who have contributed the least to climate change are currently bearing the impacts of climate change. They should not be the ones who bear the cost of mitigation actions. At this moment, about 2.5 billion people live in the semi-arid and dry regions of the world. These are very fragile ecosystems, very vulnerable to even small changes in climate. Communities living here need to be supported to adapt their livelihoods to the changing climate. This may involve sustainable intensification of agriculture, promotion of agroecological practices on a very large scale, partnership with private sector, and providing them access to scientific research and technologies. At this moment, also 200 to 500 million people rely on pastoral livelihoods. They're spread across 75% of the countries in the world. Again, pastoral livelihoods are highly sensitive to small changes in the climate. These people need support of research and development, of extension, to adapt to the changing climate, but also to transform their livelihoods as needed. 30% of the food that is produced today is wasted. Reducing food waste and loss at every level, including in the household, is a very important measure to deal with the pressures of climate change on food security. Finally, it's very important that people in the global north who have a rich diet, rich in land-based and livestock-based proteins, adapt their diets to more sustainable ones, leaving some carbon space and opportunity for the poor and the disprivileged to grow and develop.